The water levels have risen considerably in recent days, posing a significant danger to both motorists and pedestrians attempting to cross. We interacted with some residents who cross the river on a daily basis, and they narrated the struggle they go through and how expensive it is for them to cross using canoes. They pay between 1,000 to 5,000 shillings each single journey. Whenever this river floods, crossing becomes a challenge. The canoes are few and slow down transport, and we reach our destinations very late. We ask authorities to help us. Currently, there are so many people who want to cross, but the canoes are very few. Those who deal with perishable products are at a huge risk, as most of their products go bad. Nicholas Agaba, a canoe operator, says they have been able to earn from the canoe services that are being sought by many. I charge 1,000 shillings for each person crossing, and in a day I make 20,000 shillings. But I also charge 5,000 shillings for a motorcycle crossing.
Not to risk by just, you know, crossing on foot, because the water is too heavy. They should all at all times use the canoes, but also ensure that the canoes are not overloaded.
Gad Bender, the country director of World Voices Uganda, says that many people are finding difficulty in accessing services ever since the floods cut off the bridge.
So they are finding it a very big problem to cross. Some of the children, actually, of the refugees, are studying in the schools in the host community. They cannot access the host community of the neighboring district. Now, we have few canoes. These canoes are also dilapidated.
The floods also pose a risk of disease outbreak, and he says most sanitation and hygiene services are required to ensure proper hygiene.
There is an increase in spread of diseases, waterborne diseases, issues of cholera, issues, because right now you can see people are here waiting. There are no toilets. So where do you think the people are going to ease themselves from?
The rampant floods across the country have been attributed to wetland encroachment and environmental degradation.
This river has been encroached, so it needs to be restored. The banks, the river banks, have been encroached.
This flooding follows a series of other floods that have cut off several road connections, including River Kafu that connects Kibale District, Hoima District, Chankwanzi District, Nakaseke District, Nakasongola District, and Masindi District. Report by Thomas Tumwebaze for the news.